Hey, how's it going? In this video, I'm going to show you how to save money when buying digital copies of your favorite movies for pennies on the dollar. If you're looking to build a large library of digital movies but don't want to break the bank, then this video's for you. And real quick, before we start talking about where to buy digital movies, it is important to note that you need a place on which you will redeem and watch these movies after you've purchased them. I personally prefer Movies Anywhere in combination with Vudu for the all-around ease of use and cool features like lending out your digital movies to friends. If you're new to Movies Anywhere or digital content altogether, don't worry, I've got you covered in another video, which I have linked in the description below, which will tell you how to get all that set up. Okay, when I'm looking to add to my digital movie collection, I'm primarily looking at three different sources. And the first is the wonderful community over at the Blu-ray.com forums, which has been around for about a decade. After creating your account at Blu-ray.com, you'll be free to buy and sell digital movies with other users at the site. I've been a member of this community for several years and have had nothing but great experiences. So navigating to the specific threads on the forum where you actually do the buying and selling takes several clicks, and honestly, I get lost trying to find it myself. So I have it bookmarked, and I've provided the direct link to the buying and selling threads in the description below. Before you can access the threads, you do have to create a free Blu-ray.com account. And if you're hesitant to go create another account at another website, I'm telling you, the value here is great and there's really no reason not to use this resource. I understand that there may be some of you that are a little bit hesitant sending money to a random stranger on the internet in hopes of receiving digital goods in return, but the Blu-ray.com forums do have a really cool feedback system which gives each user on there a trading score. So you're able to see if they've provided positive experiences to people in the past, which provides a little bit of peace of mind when you're working with these people. Again, I have never had an issue. I have always gotten the code when I've sent money, and the code has always redeemed perfectly. And that does it for the Blu-ray forum, which again is my favorite and first stop when I'm looking for a digital movie to add to my collection. If I'm not able to find what I'm looking for over on the Blu-ray forums, I typically head over to the Digital Code Sell subreddit over on Reddit. And again, for that one, I will provide the link in the description below. If you're already a Reddit user, you may prefer this option over the first one just because you're familiar with the Reddit ecosystem. But I'll say that I do generally struggle to snatch up the movies that I'm looking for, especially if they're new releases, just because this is such an active subreddit and people are watching that thing like hawks. So if there's a new release out there that like just dropped today and you're really wanting it, have that refresh button ready and be ready to pounce. That said, it's another great community for buying digital codes to add to your collection in a community of like-minded movie lovers. Finally, as a last resort, I will use random websites on the internet to try to find codes that I may have not been able to find on either of the previous two options. These are typically really obscure titles or maybe really old titles that individuals don't tend to have anymore. And there are some really good websites out there that will get you these codes at a relatively discounted price, but generally not as cheap as you can get them from those first two options we covered. All that said, I don't want to spend time going to 20 different websites searching for a movie, hoping that I will eventually find it and comparing prices and all that stuff. I love to use a tool called UV Spider. Again, link in the description. It's so nice to go to uvspider.com, type in the movie I'm looking for, and then see a list of results at various retailers and the price each retailer is selling it at. And this option honestly felt the most sketch out of any of the options before. Some of these websites look like they were built in 1995, but UV Spider does have a verified flag next to the verified sellers, and it will also put a warning label on any sellers that have maybe had bad reports in the past. So don't buy from those and buy from the verified ones. And I wouldn't be recommending this if I've had any problems in the past, and this is another one where I have bought several movies and have never once had a problem. So I feel completely comfortable recommending this option to you when you're looking for digital movies for yourself. So the main reason I say that this is my last resort is because, again, the prices are not generally that competitive. In fact, there have been times that I've come out to UV Spider, found a code, almost bought it, and then went and looked at like Vudu or iTunes and found it for cheaper, which is pretty weird and totally defeats the purpose. Now, those occasions are rare, and generally UV Spider will get you a result that is $5 to $10 cheaper than you'll find most other places. Now, one major benefit this option has over either of the first two is that you typically will get instant delivery of the code. So if I'm sitting down on a Friday night with my wife and we've got a movie in mind that we want to watch and I don't own it, I might actually come here first as opposed to going to a forum, because if I go to a forum and I send money to somebody, I'm gonna have to wait. I'm gonna have to hope that they see that I paid them and hope that they're able to get online and email me a code. Whereas these options are typically automated and their systems automatically generate an email back to me after they've received payment with the digital code. So you can buy a movie and have it redeemed and be watching it all in about a 5 minute window. So again, if I'm in a time crunch, I'm totally willing to spend the extra couple of dollars in order to get that instant delivery. All right, those are my top three sources for buying digital movies. If you know of any other digital movie marketplaces, be sure to let us know in the comments. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next one.